AskReddit. Reddit, what is your worst moment of I probably shouldn't hang out with these people? They laughed at me when I put my seatbelt on. It was the last time I went out with them. When I pulled out a test kit to make sure what we had was actually MDMA, and they all called me a paranoid nerd. Excuse me for valuing my brain and my life, and wanting to know what I'm putting in my body. Oh, and it turned red, which means it was primarily meth or meth based, but yeah, I'm paranoid. They broke into my house, got incredibly drunk, trashed the place, set fire to a trash can on my fucking roof, vomited on my bed, which then cascaded onto the floor, and then left it all for me to clean up. When I told them to fuck off and never contact me again, they responded that I'd be missing out on good times. Re-i-i-t. Edit. A lot of you are curious why I didn't press charges slash kick their asses slash call the cops. I should clarify that I'd been friends with these guys since we were kids. They used to be great people, and perhaps because of that, I let sentimentality get the better of me. No matter how mad I was about what they did, I didn't want to take legal action. Nothing expensive was damaged. Just one extremely burnt trash can. Never seeing them again was enough for me. Being with these people was like being in an emotionally abusive relationship. They talked about me behind my back, ignored me, talked over me, and went places without bothering to ask if I wanted to go. We lived in a small town and social opportunities were limited, so I put up with it longer than I should've. We were all in our mid-20s, and it was like being in middle school again. After a while, I started thinking the problem was me, and that I was just a socially awkward freak. When I realized how terrible I felt about myself, I knew it was time to cut them out of my life, and I have never really looked back. Life is much better without them in it. When I figured out everyone's hobbies were getting as drunk as possible, posting on social media about getting as drunk as possible, posting pictures on social media where everyone is a picture of you holding an alcoholic beverage, wanting to travel to other countries for the sole purpose of getting fucked up in them. The guy's only interests were sports and partying. The girl's only interests were shopping, popular media, and partying. Drugs. These people are fun to hang out with sometimes, until you reach like 23, but then the basicness becomes pretty much unbearable. I was leaving a store with three of my friends. One friend and I got into my car, and were about to leave, when another announced that he had to pee. He then climbed into the back of my other friend's car, and found a 1-gallon Ziploc bag, and started urinating into it. The owner of that car was in the driver's seat laughing his ass off, when he proceeded to pull a jar of Jif out of the glove box, and start eating it with his bare hands. All of this was happening in the parking lot of a store that had a large glass window in the front, so that everyone in the store could see them. The store also had a restroom. Okay, so this is super late, but I hope someone sees it. This happened about 10 years ago. I had been seeing this girl casually for a few weeks, and she invited me out to a show. I drove her and her roommates to the place, and we went in. At the door, the bouncer waves her and her roommate through. He puts his arm out, and he's like, "Are you with her?" To which I respond, "Yes." He tells me there's a $20 cover and I pay, whatever. So, we are sitting there listening to some sweet jams, and she wants to dance. We start doing our thing, and she's all over me. Super cool, but I already knew I was going to get some. I noticed every time I look over to the door, the bouncer is just fucking glaring at us. Whatever, he's a douche, let him go. Well, the show ends. Everyone is kinda drunk, so I drive them home. I'm the DD. When we get back to her place, I know I'm spending the nights, so I do a few shots to catch up. We just chill, smoke a little, and watch Magnolia. I don't know why, but they love that movie. Anyways, at about 2 or 3 in the morning, there is a heavy knock on the door. The roommate goes to answer it, and what the fuck, it's the bouncer. The roommate and the bouncer go upstairs. Well, they're upstairs for a while, so my lady friend goes up to check on them. After about 5 minutes, the bouncer comes downstairs. This is where it gets hairy. He says to me, "You know, she doesn't need assholes like you taking advantage of you. She can do better." My response, "Okay, pal, whatever." He continues on that rant for a while, and I keep blowing him off. This does not sit well with him, so he pulls a fucking knife out to show me he's serious. He says, "You need to leave right now, or I will fucking gut you." At that exact moment, the roommate comes downstairs and says, "Hey, what the fuck are you doing?" The bouncer is caught off guard and puts his knife away. "Bouncer, I'm just fucking with him. Isn't this guy an asshole?" Roommate, "That's not cool, man. Don't fucking threaten my friends. I'm now this guy's friend because I drove him to a show. See? Bouncer, I'll do whatever the fuck I want." At this point, the bouncer goes on about how he's a super badass 1%er biker dude. The roommate fucking called him on it, stone cold. "Who do you know?" The bouncer couldn't respond. My new friend pulls out his cell phone and makes a call. We all hear, "Hey, do you know such and such a guy?" "I thought so. Where you at?" "Oh, you should stop by." Not even 5 minutes later, I hear the roar of a loud ass motorcycle, followed by a chorus. They sound like angels. The bouncer bolts, and we hear some shouting, some wet meat sounding thumping, and then the roar of the bikes. The bouncer never came back inside. I swear to fucking god I drove a hippie girl and her biker roommate to a concert. The bouncer at the concert knew the girl, and was pissed that she was there with another man. Threatened to kill me, and then the fucking Hell's Angels showed up to watch my back. Obviously I never went back over there again, though I did see the girl a few more times, until she ended up in rehab. Got a job at a bar slash restaurant down the street from my parents' house washing dishes, when I was 18 and in school. Going for my first day at the time they told me to, nobody is there. Head chef shows up an hour later. Gets me started. First half of day goes fairly well, then the second chef shows up around 3 p.m. Stays 20 minutes, disappears. Day is progressing fairly normally, but I'm seeing disgusting things that make me never want to eat there again. Guys smoking cigs in the kitchen, not practicing sanitary food handling habits, stuff like that. But the moment I realized I shouldn't hang out with them came when the second chef showed back up around 6 p.m. waving around a decent sized bag of cocaine and everybody was laughing and getting excited about divvying it up. He proceeds to grab a clean cutting board, divides out the bag evenly between everybody in the kitchen, me included, but I wanted nothing to do with it and got rid of it, and hands out little bags of coke for each staff member. He then pulls out one of those little cash bags banks give you for storing deposits, and pulls out a much larger bag of coke, grabs a scale from somewhere, and gets down to business. For the rest of my shift, apps 5 hours, anytime an order came in for a pizza with special cheese, at least one small bag of coke would be placed under the pizza in the box. They were dealing coke out of the kitchen. I finished my shift, left, and never went back, even to pick up my paycheck for my 12-hour shift. Fuck that. The place was raided by police about 3 weeks later. I don't have many friends. That is something I have understood and can readily accept. I have realized I'm extremely selective in finding confidants and true close friends, as I find it extremely hard to completely trust someone. Before that, however, I was on the fringes of the popular group and had many friends. I realized that these people never actually sought out for me. It was always me starting the conversations, me making plans to meet up, which they never actually bothered to follow through with, and they never even invited me to anything. So I stopped wasting my time and surrounded myself with people who actually want to be there. At my daughter's circle welcoming, sort of like a paganing ceremony, a newish friend got down on the floor with the kids to play with blocks. It was cute, until he built what looked like two Jenga towers and flew toy planes into them, laughing hysterically. This was just days before the anniversary of September 11th. Everyone there was military or law enforcement. Two people walked out so as not get into a fight with him, since it was an important day, but man, once the guy left and the ceremony was over, did we get an earful. Never saw them again. I used to go to church with my mom, aunt, and cousin until I was about 13. I hated it, but went because afterwards my mom rewarded me by taking me to Red Robin. Religion never stuck with me, and I made no secret that I wasn't into the whole church scene. I'd have to go to the youth group, where all of the kids went, when the adults were in real church. The kids were fucking horrible, and had a huge chip on their shoulder, because they believed in God, and I didn't, hence they were superior yet still bragged about giving BJS and smoking pot. I don't care if someone is religious or not, but what I can't stand is when someone talks the talk until they are blue in the face, but can't live the ideals they preach. Even Red Robin wasn't worth hanging out with those losers. I grew up in a small town and was, I guess, weird. The people I hung out with in middle and high school were from well-off, traditional two-parent families with nice, new houses, white-collar jobs, multiple cars, etc. I'm the only child of a single mom, who worked a factory job. We lived paycheck to paycheck, beat a car, tiny old house. I lived pretty far away from everyone, so I could only go to things if my mom could give me a ride. They stopped inviting me as much. Junior year prom. They talk about plans in front of me and then told me that I wasn't invited because they thought I had other plans. Senior year, I started dating a guy and suddenly there wasn't enough room at the lunch table. During a get together, they were planning a trip to someone's family cabin and wanted $100 from everyone for alcohol. I got really quiet because there was no way in hell I could ask my mother for $100 for something so frivolous as underage drinking. That was what I was allowed to spend for back to school shopping. They went around the circle and I finally said that I didn't think I'd be able to afford it, and everyone basically stopped talking to me, turned their backs to me, and continued with their planning. When I was 15, I went to stay to New Zealand over Christmas and New Year's to stay with the exchange student that had lived with us. For New Year's, we went to Lake Taupo to celebrate, where I took a tumble off some cliffs by the beach and smashed my face so it swelled, making me look like a balloon with eyes. On our way back, we stopped at a small town to visit some friends and of course we kept drinking. We went to a pub and I got wasted beyond recognition. I decided to make my way back to the house we were staying in. Trouble was, I had no idea where that was, and I just started walking towards where I thought it was. I was pretty hammered when we went to the pub, so it was pretty random which way I was going. I remember seeing a light down the end of the road of an intersection I passed, and I thought, what the hell, it might as well be here, and walked over. When I get to the light, it's above what seems like a auto shop with two Maori biker dudes in full on leather pants and leather vests are sitting on some scrummy old plastic chairs by the door. I hear music pump in from the garage and the walking had put me back into what I believed was good shape. Heeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee don't think it's your kind of party. Boosting with confidence, I'm all about partying, and say they should let me in cause I'll liven up things inside for sure. Okay, go ahead I guess, and they let me in. Inside there's a party, just like you would expect any outlaw biker party to be. Sort of like dusk till dawn. They lead me inside and count me a beer. I start chugging, and some people came up to talk. A couple of years earlier a movie had came out called Warrior Soul or something in the likes of that, which was around Maori bikers, sorta, so I went on a rant around the movie, stating I for sure knew all about how organized crime amongst Maori bikers worked, based on what I had seen in a movie. Some of them, I think really took offense, but my alcohol level ignored any warning signals. The last I remembered was the bouncers dragging me out by my arms and throwing me on the ground outside. Tensions were high to say the least. Suddenly we hear someone yelling from down the road. It's my buddy who had went out looking for me and by pure luck walked by just as they were throwing me out. He ran over and some intense diplomacy commenced. I naturally was talking high and wide how I had a right to be there blah blah blah. Then my buddy turns to me and say just take a look at them. I look up, and I notice how all of them are covered in face tattoos, and have fire in their eyes. Then it clicked for me. These guys wanted blood. I went pale as a sheet, and